every year, pastoralists in Karamoja region, northeastern Uganda, lose up to 50% of their cows due to East Coast fever, a disease that kills hundreds of thousands of cows in sub-Saharan Africa. In 2013, government, together with other partners, conducted a pilot campaign in Kacheri sub-county, Kotido district, to raise awareness about the benefits of using ECF vaccine to save the cow.
East Coast fever has been one of the challenging primary diseases of importance to the livestock keeper in Karamoja. It's been one of the diseases that attention has not been clearly given because challenges of treating it or preventing it has been very scarce in the area. And through the St. Mary's United Methodist Church Foundation funding, we had really little funds that could not support most of the families that have livestock, especially cows. So we were very happy we contacted government. This has been one of the pilots that we have been dreaming about, that we have been wishing it would happen, and now it came to reality. It was very difficult to raise the 80 cows in the village because most people were very, very, very unsure, very doubtful on the success of this vaccine, and they feared risking their few animals to a vaccine that has not been tested in the area.
So I told the members, let us vaccinate our calves. Don't fear, because the government or a development partner cannot bring something for killing our animals.
When everything went on well, all the rest of the communities were like, oh, this vaccine is really good. And they appreciate it because the way these animals browse in this patchy environment, sometimes when it's really, really very dry, these animals manage and try to survive compared to the non-vaccinated animals.
I go to the field, I send mobilize and tell them on a day when the exercise will take place, then the venue, then all those things, we meet with the what? With that NGO, then we come to the field together, together with the community. Yes, then we take the exercise.
When you look at this vaccination campaign, they have begun to pick up interest just within their households. Sometimes the community might be not interested as a whole community, but households are mobilizing themselves, teaming up to see that they can be able to vaccinate these animals using their own resources.
By end of 2015, more than 1,700 calves will have been vaccinated in 22 villages, and following the successful campaigns, government and other partners will continue to make available the ECF vaccine on a commercial basis to continue protecting livestock in this area against East Coast fever.
We are happy the government has also come up, they have put in into their plan, and they want to take advantage when the November vaccinations come in this very year. Then they'll take advantage and vaccinate at least about 500 to 1,000 calves.